commitment.
Thank you.
Can I give you guys at least some water? Nothing else. You need something to drink, don't you?
No.
No.
Not for me.
Nothing?
For me either.
Okay. Thank you.
So you met
the...
Oh, there's plenty more. Just
Ryan Hall.
Ryan
Hall. Because he is injured.
He cannot run tomorrow. I mean,
not
Monday.
Running, but there was another person who won the bronze for the United States. And I saw him, but I didn't talk to him. And he's originally from, well, he looks African American, but he's not from Africa. He's from
Africa. I'm just going to leave that.
No, the one that was.
Oh, the wand is. Oh,
no, the man.
Some control. It'll serve you on the hills in a couple of miles. This downhill is going right into Newton lower
levels.
Just went through 25 kilometers. Marathon is 42 kilometers. Now, folks, in my opinion, coming up to one of the toughest part of the courses. When we're crossing over a major roadway of Route 95, Route 28, way just ahead is a very strong crosswind and there's no protection. It's all wide open. And this is really an emotional thing to get through this section coming up just past this light where you're totally exposed. This serves as some kind of an appetizer before the hills. We're entering Newton officially now.
Newton now.
Still on Route 16, that will take us into right
Newton.
To the intersection of Commonwealth.
Newton.
Alright folks, as you can tell, it's a little deceptive, but we are going up here, crossing
the supposed to be the
section.
You mean then
the hospital, but it's
discouraging until you get to the other side.
It's just not the hospital, so I don't
know. Oh yeah. So here we are folks.
Hospital.
This will be challenging for the next quarter mile.
The hospital, medical center.
At the top runners. Thank you.
Okay. Ya. Mañana corro. Tiene que I'm out of there. Okay, be closer. I'm going to be there. Be closer to you. Closer to you. Closer to you.
Identified a beast on a picture. That picture, whether we have a name or not, we don't know. And that person will be hopefully found because the United States isn't that big, and hopefully they didn't get on an airplane. And that's just all we know right now. We can't confirm. But the fact we're at that moment where we have a picture is excellent. I mean, this is good news. It may not be the news everyone in Boston or the United States wants, but it's pretty good.
A picture and also the remnants of the device itself.
Right.
With perhaps identifiable numbers, the serial numbers on them, or
identifiable,
right. That might be able to be tracked down the
river. Right. As I said, you want the right person and a guilty verdict, and those take time. And so the fact, the speed, the government's not being judged by speed right now.
Sure.
The damage has already been done, and it's now just going to be judged, did you get the conviction?
Well, my folks, you work with the Joint Terrorism Task Force. How difficult is it when you have dozens of government agencies, state, federal, local, all in a room trying to work toward a common cause? Obviously, everybody.
What did you eat in your house?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, they've been quiet enough.
And
it's too hot. Everything's moving. It's too hot.
No, muscle. No, the meat.
Name's meat. I had a chin. In Japan,
sure. Thank you so much, and it was so helpful knowing that I knew I was going to be able to see you.
Boston Marathon, Peoria and Juliet Wu is thankful to be alive and thankful her time of 3 hours and 58 minutes may have saved the lives of others. Running is a big part of Juliet Wu's life.
Give me coffee in the morning and give me chocolate and I will be your friend. But if you run with me, you'll be my friend forever.
She made a friend for life last week. Running in her first Boston Marathon, Juliet ran alongside a man who was in his 28th Boston Marathon. They finished 10 minutes before the blast went off at the finish line.
We all heard the explosion. It sounded like fireworks, and we thought that they were celebrating Patriots Day. Soon afterwards, there was a huge gust of wind as strong as a tornado, and we realized much later that it was attributed to the bomb.
Knowing his typical pace, Juliet's running mate, Joe Sikora of New Jersey, looked at his watch and told her she may have saved his life.
Had he not run with me, he said that he may have just been right at the explosion, which would have been 10 minutes slower.
Timing was also on the side of Juliet's parents, who made the trip from Chicago and were on their way to congratulate their daughter minutes after she finished the race.
I was behind the bomb. Yeah. I had finished. They were in front of the bomb. Had they been faster, 700 feet faster, they would have been right at the bombing.
Running may be a big part of her life, but now Juliet Wu appreciates life after her marathon running.